simple things in life make me happy. Happy where the simple things in life make me happy, yeah. Listen up, just the other day I was out in my garden with my hands digging down in the mud. Underneath my fingernails, all of my wrists with the warm, muddy Mother Earth hug. Well, the seeds go down and the plants grow up in the sun and the rain. Fill the loving cup, it makes me happy. Yeah, the simple things in life can make me happy. Just the other day, like a big warm cat, come and sit down in my lap after a day like today, which is to say it was a hard day. Cat don't notice the crease in my brow. She is a booty cat concerned with the here and now. And now I'm feeling cozy, life is looking rosy. Ain't it funny how it doesn't always take another drug to make me happy? Cause the simple things in life make me happy. Mm-hmm. Oh, I said they made me happy. Yeah, yeah. Well, the simple things in life can make me happy. That's my newest song called Happy. I like to get that out of the way first because most of the other music is kind of depressing.
Well, and that's an original, right?
Yeah.
I think when songs are called Happy, we should give people credit for writing them themselves because I've heard some covers. But anyway, Jeff Arrigo is our guest star tonight on Web Sessions. And again, for those of you who are new in town, because I, based on the traffic downtown, can tell there are a lot of you who are either new in town or back, we bring you a live concert every night from the Great Hall here at WEFT 113 North Market Street, and that is largely courtesy of sound engineer Mike Feldman, without whom I could DJ, but we wouldn't actually have live music.
But not
or
every night.
Every Monday.
Monday.
Did I? Every Monday night. Did I say every night?
Yes, you did.
Well,
And that would overwork me.
Well, I would not expect you to be here seven nights a week, although I realize it wouldn't be the first person who did, but that would be unreasonable and insane. But yes, we have live music every Monday night. And as I was saying, I could announce, but you wouldn't be able to hear the music, and it wouldn't be a good show. And the show is made possible by Mike Feldman being sound engineer, Mike Ingram being booking agent, and people, great people like Jeff Arrigo, who come and do the show. So, Jeff, it's your hour. Anything you want to talk about?
Well, I'd like to say thank you to both mics for having me here and making me sound as good as as possible. I don't know. As good as it is possible for me to sound. I would just say I'm going to play a bunch of songs tonight. Well, I don't know about a bunch, but two or three or so.
Oh, a bunch.
That are really place songs, and the place that they're about is the Missouri Ozarks, which is my favorite place in the world and where I've spent a lot of time. So I travel there a lot. We float there and camp there, and I just get a lot of inspiration from that part of this country. So I'm going to play some songs kind of set in that location.
Did you come here from there, or did you just like to visit there?
More or less. We're kind of on the northern edge of the Ozark Plateau is where we moved from Columbia, Missouri. But just a stone's throw, you know, into the hollers and the streams. And the rivers and stuff down in the Ozarks.
Champaign-Urbana had a nationally acclaimed DJ go from Champaign-Urbana straight to Columbia, Missouri. So that's what keeps it on my radar, not having been there myself.
Very similar place, actually. It's a huge university, small city, almost the exact same size or, you know, similar sized. A lot of the same feelings, you know, good music scene, good food, interesting people. Kind of a liberal pocket. Of course, most of Illinois is more liberal, but in Missouri, Columbia is definitely the liberal pocket, surrounded by a lot of red area.
You haven't been to Villa Grove, have you?
Well, you know.
No, I get it. Yeah. So you have some songs, and I don't want to delay you.
So there's this place down in the Missouri Ozarks called the Irish Wilderness, and it's a pretty wild place, and there's a river running through it called the 11 Point. And you can get lost down in those woods. And it's real close to the Arkansas border. So when I was a kid, I used to watch a lot of these movies on KPLR, I believe it was, Channel 11. They'd play the old movies like Bonnie and Clyde. And there's this one movie called Vanishing Point that I loved. And it was just like this, all those old movies about gangsters were like, you knew they weren't gonna make it, but you're kind of rooting for them, kind of like the anti-hero. And that's kind of where I got the inspiration for this song, along with just that part of the Missouri Ozarks. This is called The Irish Wilderness. Just 5 miles from Arkansas, running toward those Ozark Mountains, heading for the state line. I got rollers on my heel. Hasn't been but 5 days since I hit the Irish wilderness, and I plan to hide along that Ozark stream. I may get out too soon to tell. I've always had my Irish luck, and it's treated me so well. Nothing but the road under my wheels. So just 5 more miles to Arkansas, 5 miles, and I'll be free. See, I thought that I could hit that joint, disappear into the night. I'd lay low on the river till they all forgot my name. Yeah, but nothing went the way I planned. My hand shook and I shot a man, and I learned that easy money is the fastest way to hell. I stood there till the smoke had cleared, the gunshot ringing in my ears. I realized the life I knew would never be the same. Just like the man that I shot down, my dreams and plans all dead and gone. Ain't nothing guaranteed except what's wrong is always wrong. I may get out too soon to tell. I've always had that Irish luck, and it's treated me so well. Nothing but the road under my wheels. Just 4 more miles to Arkansas, 4 miles, and I'll be free. From Alton down to Riverton, and I headed north for Fiddler Spring. Up on White's Creek Holler, that's where I planned to disappear. Well, I hunkered down, the nights were cold. Fear was working on my soul. Every time I closed my eyes, I saw a dead man's face. I had to build a fire to warm the cold that worked into my bones. By the time I saw the smoke fill up the sky, it was too late. Come an Ozark County deputy, yeah, but I saw him before he saw me. And I raised that devil's instrument, and I brought him to his knees. I may get out too soon to tell. I've always had that Irish luck, and it's treated me so well. Nothing but the road under my wheels. Just 3 more miles to Arkansas, 3 miles, and I'll be free. I knew that it was time to go, so I grabbed that police radio. I took his gun and I left that dying man just lying there on the ground. I headed south, Highway 19. Soon I heard the siren scream, but a raging river does not pay attention to the banks. The state line is approaching fast. They don't aim to let me pass, but I ain't in a talking mood. This world can kiss my ass. See, there's one thing that they have not guessed. I've been dead these 5 days since I shot a man in cold blood. I got nothing left to lose. I may get out too soon to tell. I've always had that Irish luck and it's treated me so well. Nothing but the road under my wheels. Just 2 more miles to Arkansas, 2 miles and I'll be free. Well, I may get out too soon to tell. I've always had that Irish luck and it's treated me so well. Nothing but the road under my wheels. Just 1 more mile to Arkansas. 1 more mile to Arkansas. 1 more mile to Arkansas.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, well, you know, it was a little bit of a hard move coming to Illinois, primarily because, you know, I was used to those Arkansas hills and rivers and stuff. So I guess I want to play a song that this is like the first song, like when I was recognizing some of the beauty around here. And it was a couple years in. There's some beauty in the prairies and the stuff here. And so I was up at the most far north, what do they call them? The county forest preserves. I can't remember the name of the one that's the furthest north, but that's where I was. Yeah. And it was a beautiful fall day, like late September. Those are parks, I think. This is a forest preserve. It's not River Bend, it's further north.
Mike said something.
Penfield.
Sure.
This will challenge all the new students to get to know, to Google their new community and see what it is.
Yeah, hike out the forest preserves. They're nice and they're uncrowded and you can have some nice time out there. Okay, so nice, beautiful late September day. The corn was beautiful. The sky was blue.
Well, grasshopper, grasshopper, why do you scatter when I'm out walking through the high meadow? The September sunshine, the breeze that bends the corn. Everything that's here today, tomorrow will be gone. The sweet Sagamon River, where are you flowing? Your ripples push you past these muddy banks. The September sunshine, the breeze that bends the corn. Everything that's here today, tomorrow will be gone. And now you're gone across the country in some other's arms. I'm sitting in this empty house, so lonesome. Canadian geese seem to know something I don't. They seem to understand when summer's gone. The September sunshine, the breeze that bends the corn. Everything that's here today, tomorrow will be gone.
And now you're gone across the country in some other's arms. I'm lonely in this empty house, it's so lonesome. The September sunshine falls across the floor. Our summer love is over, you don't love me anymore. Sweet Mary, why did you go? Our summer love is over, you don't love me anymore. Yes, and everything that's here today, tomorrow will be gone. Thank you. All right, I guess I'm going on. Oh, here he comes.
We were just talking WEFFest and other upcoming events we're looking forward to, but at the same time enjoying your song. Yeah. So that's the worst part of host. I love hosting this show, but I hate that I have to multitask while you're playing, because I'd love to just, you know, stand here and not like be a vulture or anything, but give you my undivided attention. But then it
would be creepy if you were standing right there by the microphone staring at me. So,
well, I tend to agree. It would this close would be maybe a little awkward. Anyway, so you came here from Arkansas?
From Missouri.
Missouri,
yeah.
That's what I thought at first, but yeah. It's always, I love that Champaign is so much of a melting pot, or Champaign-Urbana, I guess.
Yeah.
I came here long distance myself, so. How long you been here?
We're 5 years in July, so wow. It's been a long time, but half of us are leaving in 3 days, and the other half, that'd be my wife, mm-hmm. is leaving for England.
Oh, my.
She took a job as a professor at a university over there, uh-huh. and I'll be following close behind.
Will we see you again, I hope?
I hope so, but yeah, maybe not as often.
Well, it'll just be a bigger deal when we do.
Yeah.
And you can pick up a little bit of the accent so that no matter where you are, everybody thinks you're from the other place.
Right, exactly.
We were just talking about that before the show, so. Anyway. Oh, did you want to give out booking information, website, any of that?
Yeah. I was in China this summer teaching and then took a swing through Vietnam. So I haven't been around to book much. So if anyone's interested, probably the best way is through contacting me on my Facebook page, which is Jeff Arrigo Music. Or I guess my regular Facebook page is just Jeff Arrigo. So anyway, at either place.
I would think there are a lot of Jeffs, but Arrigo, I don't know too many.
Yeah,
so.
Arrigo. It's very Italian. It's very Italiano.
Do you? Is there a part of Italy that you consider ancestral? Or
My dad says Sicily.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've explained to people that the whole concept of looking Italian is based on the fact that Southern Italians all came over here, and Northern Italians mostly stayed there, so...
Well, you know more than I knew right there.
Northern Italy is, like, blonde and blue-eyed, and Southern Italy is more what we think of as Italian because they came to New Jersey. But Italy is a great place to visit.
I haven't been there, but I'd like to go.
You'll be a lot closer, so...
Yeah, from England, it's an easy visit. I'm sure we'll be there.
Well, I'm thinking as far as booking information, maybe... people in England can book you a lot more easily than people over here if they get word. So to all you Englanders, this guy.
They love the folk music over in England. Maybe I can make a go of it.
Well, what do you have for us next?
Let's see. I'll play a good old-fashioned. I'm getting ready to leave America, so I'll say some angry things about it. So. No, not of that. Not exactly that. So I do write the occasional protest song, and this is not necessarily a protest song, but it does say something about the short nature of our vision. That sounds a little bit off, but I think we're gonna have to go with it. This is called Sam Alamore's Lament. Thank you. My name is Samuel J. Ellen Moore, and I'm the last man who wants to go to war. Yeah, I'm the last man to draw a line in the sand. I guess I learned my lessons back in Vietnam. I went through hell, made it home alive. I got me a job working 9 to 5 at this government contract munitions plant. And I got busy living with my head in the sand. Started a family, life was great. Long summer weekends out at Horseshoe Lake. Starry night skies, not so warm. Little Sammy Jr. hanging on my arm, yeah. I never asked, didn't wanna know what happened to all this stuff when it clears the door. All these bullets, all these guns, all these magazines. I guess we sell them to the rebels fighting overseas. Those rebels win and they run the show. All those weapons that we sold them just as good as gold. Did we think they'd turn to plowshares when the fighting's through? Hell no, they shoot just fine at Americans too. What can you do when your life is great? All summer weekends out at Horseshoe Lake. Sunny skies, skin so tan, little Sammy Jr. turning into a man. Sam went to college, only lasted 1 year. Came home with news that I didn't want to hear. Said he was looking for a little bit more. He signed on the line, now he's in the Corps. Now the Corps don't quibble and the Corps don't guess. They're the first to arrive and everything's a mess. First to pull the trigger when the things get hot. My boy Sam, he was the first to get shot. Wish I'd never told Sammy about Vietnam. I wish he'd never gone to soldier like his old man. I wish I'd never shook the devil's hand to make a buck. Well, that devil's got a handshake that brings bad luck. I still remember when life was great. All those weekends out at Horseshoe Lake. Sunny skies, skin so tan. Little Sammy Jr. playing in the sand. I can still see my boy playing in the sand. My name is Samuel J. Ellen Moore. Not much left of me anymore. I got a flag on the mantle about the size of my soul. I don't make it out to Horseshoe much anymore. I don't make it out to Horseshoe Lake anymore.
I told you the rest of them were depressing.
We had a harmonica malfunction there. Or was it a user malfunction? I'm not sure.
Nothing more depressing than a malfunctioning harmonica. Actually, I could think of some things, but...
Yeah.
Harmonica's nice. More people should include it.
A lot of people say less people should include it. I don't know.
I'm not one of those people.
It's fewer, not less.
Fewer, yes. That's why I correct them that way.
Is there a particular camp that says less harmonica? Because... I would be curious to know their reasons.
I don't know, classically trained musicians.
Well, the only criticism I can remember of harmonica was I was reading some kind of music criticism, and they said, the only instrument Alanis Morissette plays is a harmonica, and that doesn't count as an instrument. And I thought, you just probably can't play it. you know, I mean, it just
seems
like
she's no John Popper, but...
I'm not saying she's a great, you know, I don't know her primarily as playing the harmonica, but I mean, to just dismiss an entire instrument, it struck me as kind of weird.
Yeah, no, I really enjoy harmonicas. And for me, it was really easy to pick up and play guitar at the same time. You could not tell by that last song, but in general, it's pretty easy to do both at the same time. And I think some people kind of struggle with that.
Well, I have owned and tried both and made absolutely no progress. So I tip my cap to you on both counts. Mm. I also can't sing.
Yeah.
This is why I'm on this side of the mic and you're on that side of the mic.
All right. My mind is halfway talking to you and halfway thinking, what am I going to play next?
That's better than if you were entirely focused on the conversation and then didn't have anything prepared, because then the show would just come to a dead halt.
Well, the hard thing is I can't really do two things like that at once. My mind doesn't split, so I'm still unprepared even though I'm thinking about it with half my brain.
Can I ask you one thing before you go
on?
Because you are going to be out of the country, I know you have, or I seem to remember you have at least one or two records.
Yeah.
So if people in your absence want a way to go on enjoying your music, how would they do that?
Let's see. CD Baby has it. You can order it through my Facebook music page. Or you can just grab me before I leave, and it's not going to be real quick for me. It'll be next summer.
Oh, so they got time to book you still.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought that a week from now you were going to be following.
I'll be here. I should have been clearer about that.
Grateful that there are more opportunities that, you know, you could come to WEFFest as a spectator or you can go to the Urbana Sweet Corn Festival as a spectator and you're under no obligation.
Yeah.
Now, what about your favorite local retailer like, I don't know, Exile on Main or...
I need to get them over to Exile on Main. They're not there right now and I need to drop them by there.
Is there anybody else that is selling new CDs and not just used CDs in downtown Champaign? Because I don't want to leave people out and play favorites. I'm just not thinking of... I always hear when I got here there were 5 independent retailers in Campustown, and that was not true. They were already down to like 2, but...
They're down to about none now.
Well, this was when I got here. Yeah. That's, you know, I've been hosting the show 11 years, but... Mm-hmm. But yeah, they say, 1995, we had Rose Records. Like, no, we had an empty storefront.
Right. It probably still said Rose Records on the front.
Maybe. I never figured out where it was, but I digress. So yay remaining independent retailers, and yay WEFF Sessions performers like you, and what do you have next for us?
Yeah. So this is a song about food, which I love. And I usually sing this a lot in the summertime because it's gardening time. So this is called Collard Greens. And it's, I thought that I made this up just out of my head, but after I wrote it and sang it a couple times and my wife heard it, she said, I told you that story about my own life. And I still don't think so, but maybe. She says that at least parts of this are biographical about her life, so.
But it's not Poke Salad Annie. It's it's at least from your family and not...
I thought I just made it up. Yeah, I thought it was completely a fiction story.
It's a mystery.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay, the collard greens. Must have been back in about 1989. It was the middle of the winter, man, times were tight. We had the heat turned down low and the blanket stacked up high to ward off that cold that was just outside. I was down in the kitchen trying to rustle me up some grub. I had a 100-mile stare going down into an empty cupboard. Then back in the corner, what's that I see? It looks like one last can of those collard greens, collard greens. Collard green, I swear it was the best thing I ever had seen. When your finances dictate a one-course meal, praise the Lord, you got your collard green.
You eat a poor man's dish when you ain't got no dough. But the poor folks figured out a long time ago where there's food to be had if you ain't too proud. But you gotta keep your head up and you gotta look around. Got your ditched lily blossoms and your dandelion leaves, cow's tongue tripe and pickled pig's feet. Well, you put it all together, that's a soul food feast. And in the middle of it all, there's always collard greens. Yeah, collard greens, oh, collard greens. Don't be afraid to cook them up and eat them. Brown sugar on molasses make them taste a lot sweeter. Best damn dish that you're ever gonna eat, yeah. Now all these years later, things are looking pretty bright. I'm eating like a king, just about every night. I got a pocket full of cash, I got a sweater on my back. I got my car keys clipped to my Eddie Bauer backpack. Can't think of one thing that I really need. If I ask for any more, that'd just be greedy. I don't need fancy shirts, I don't need designer blue jeans, but I will take seconds on those collard greens. Yeah, collard greens, collard greens. Best damn dish that you're ever gonna eat. On top of the world are of humble means, a benevolent God gives us collard greens. Collard greens, collard greens. Don't be afraid to cook them up and eat them. Brown sugar on molasses make them taste a lot sweeter. Best damn dish that you're ever gonna eat. Yeah.
Thank you. That's the collard greens. Let's sing another song kind of in that vein. This is a song kind of about me called The Quitting Smoking Blues.
When I was young and I wanted to smoke, I take a pack of cigarettes out of my daddy's coat, steal a pack of matches from the kitchen drawer. Screen door slam, I'd head out to the yard. I wish I knew then what I know now. I got the quitting smoking blues. So it's nicotine patch, nicotine patch, nicotine monkey up on my back. I gotta figure out something new I'm gonna do with my hands. But don't bet money on your best laid plan. Biggest lie ever told by man is, hey, I have just one. Quitting smoking blues. Quitting smoking blues. Now the jig is up, thrill is gone. Half empty cup starting to fill up with cigarette butts. Old ex-smokers all nicotine free, they all make it look so easy. I got the quitting smoking blues. People used to smoke at their desk in the offices downtown. Now you see those cats all out wandering around down there smoking in the streets. Or maybe you'll catch them back in the building alcoves right here in downtown Champaign, pushed outside there out of the way. One day closer till they have to face them old quitting smoking blues. Quitting smoking blues, it's a fact of life. Throw out your tailor-mades and tobacco pipes. Do it quick, don't stop and think twice.
Smash your ashtrays underneath your boots. Hold on tight, this ain't nothing new. Just those quitting smoking blues. Marlboro man, he died a couple years ago. But you know what? I heard he had himself a mansion on the ocean down in Mexico. He turned his dirty old habit into a big old shiny pile of gold. But that was a pretty long time ago. Even the Surgeon General, he said it was cool to smoke, turning a whole generation right onto those quitting smoking blues. Quitting smoking blues. Now the thrill is gone. The thrill is gone. Half empty cups starting to overflow with cigarette butts. Marginalized money spent. The casualty of a fickle government. Those quitting smoking nicotine stained smokers call. Grab that monkey boy and shake him off with those quitting smoking blues. There you go. It's a quitting smoking blues. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Let's see what we got now. I could probably go here.
Okay.
Time is it? Oh, we got time. So I played some kind of fun upbeat song. So now let's sing about death. Another song that's kind of set in the Ozarks. I have this friend John who knows a little bit about everything, and he hones his skills at giving very sharp bursts of information, teaching in an alternative high school where he knows the attention span is not going to afford him more than 3 minutes at any one time. So he was telling me one day about all the things he knew about Lycan as we were hiking around down in the Ozarks, and then I got on the Wikipedia and found out the rest. Well, lichen on your tombstone, lichen on your tombstone, lichen on your tombstone, growing round, round, lichen on your tombstone, there's gonna be some lichen on your tombstone. We're here a little while, but we're gonna fade away, you better live just how you wanna live, lichen on your tombstone. Someday we're on this solid little rock, roll around in space, cold and it's dark, ain't nothing living in this place. And man, it came from dust, dust came from the earth, earth it came from rock, cause the rock was here first. Lichen started breaking rock so many years ago, there will be lichen on the tombstone of everyone you know someday. Now moss is lichen's friend, moss is lichen's pal. They hang out together deep down in Ozark valleys, down in the valleys where beneath the Ozark moon, holding back the banks of a little Ozark stream. Behind your shut windows, behind your locked doors, where you better pay attention. The time is not too long to bear, be lichen on your tombstone. There'll be some lichen on your tombstone. That means you're gonna be dead lichen on your tombstone. Mm-hmm, gonna be some lichen on your tombstone. We're here a little while, but we're gonna fade away. You better live just how you wanna live, lichen on your tombstone. Someday. Now lichen grows on sand, lichen grows on earth, it grows on artificial structures, the buildings where you work, it grows up in the Arctic, where the Inuit tore dry rock tree trunks, dead and sterile soil. They shot it into orbit on a Russian space mission, came back 15 days later, impeccable condition, Lichen's gonna grow. Sound like this. Ain't no cause to fret. Here before you took a breath, and long after you're dead, you see the dinosaurs were here. Now the dinosaurs are gone. 400 million years till a lichen is grown strong. Ice cap's gonna melt, man, it's gonna fade away. You better kiss it all goodbye, boys. The lichen's here to stay. Lichen on your tombstone, lichen on your tombstone, lichen on your tombstone, growing round, round, lichen on your tombstone, gonna be some lichen on your tombstone. We're here a little while, but we're gonna fade away, you better live just how you wanna live. Here a little while, but we're gonna fade away, we better live just how we wanna live. We're here a little while, we're all gonna fade away. I better live just how I wanna live. It's gonna be some lichen on my tombstone someday.
I just changed that from harmonica part to mouth flugelhorn, so I'm not terribly used to playing the mouth flugelhorn, but okay, let's see what we got here. I think I'm okay. How about I do another one and then we chat or something? It's been a long time since we sat around this fire. Watch the stars come out one by one up on Harper Hill a long time. This heavy heart is tired. Sing me out a song for the ones who have slipped away. We were young once and full of grace. A camera flash, a smiling face. Kodachrome of yesterday. The colors fade, they do not stay through long years. Once we held so close and dear, one by one they disappear. Now they're gone, but we're still here, and it's been a long time. Let's sit around this fire. Let's watch the stars come down one by one up on Harper Hill. Our voices will be a benediction. We're singing songs and telling stories for the ones who have slipped away. There ain't no friend like an old friend to laugh you through the hard times. Help you know the light will shine. Even when the light looks just like night, when sorrow is at your window and goodbye is too damn forever,
Helps to know you've got someone who's known you since we both were young. God, you're here to help me through, and it's been a long time. We'll sit around this fire, we'll watch the stars come out one by one up on Harper Hill. I know that this heavy heart will grow lighter, singing songs and telling stories of the ones who have slipped away. We're singing songs and telling stories. Say goodbye, goodbye, yesterday. Goodbye, goodbye.
Thank you.
You must like harmonica. I see you have several there.
Yeah, I usually play harmonica on the Lichen song, but I really wanted to try the... just make some sounds tonight.
L-I-C-H-E-N?
Yeah.
Okay, that's not a word I hear very often in songs.
Yeah.
I hear lots of plays on words like that, but that's neat that that's actually what you mean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the little stuff that grows on stones and rocks and, I guess, tombstones if they're there long enough.
You have any songs about liverworts?
Would you like a song about liverwort?
I would love a song about a liverwort. I think one of my listeners would, but depends on how closely he's paying attention right now. We have a very engaged listenership tonight, I should say. Jess even commented on good listenership when you started. So.
Oh, good. Good, good, good. How can you tell?
Holly Rushikoff, when she hosted the show, said that we had a magical map of the United States where there would be a light everywhere somebody was listening, but that was an imaginative white lie. But we do, since then, have we have a counter for how many people are listening online.
Oh, nice.
We have no way to tell how many people are listening on real radios, but... if it used to be if we had 25 people listening online, a 26th person couldn't get on, they'd be waitlisted, and then we were able to expand, and we haven't had a problem with the new number, which I want to say is 100, but as I said, we have not had people complaining that they were 101 and unable to tune in.
Yeah.
We would be grateful to have that problem.
Well, we'll see if we can get them there.
Yeah. I should have a challenge for all people on web sessions to get 101 people listening online.
See if we can break the system.
Like cramming kids into a phone booth, which they no longer accept records for, I don't think.
There are no longer any phone booths. That's the problem.
Well, there are. They're just they don't have phones in them.
Yeah.
I've noticed little phone kiosks all over the place, and I always check them to see if they have a phone, and they don't.
Yeah.
But one quick question. Because we always talk before the last song, I'm assuming this is not a 10-minute song.
It's on the longer side, so this would probably be it.
Okay, Mike, how long do we have? Okay, I think he's saying that it's fine for this to be the last song, and...
yeah, we got 5 minutes.
Okay, well, I should be ready to start the next hour, so I'd like to thank you for being here with us. Maybe give out your website one more time?
Yeah, Jeff Arrigo Music on Facebook. If you just search for Jeff Arrigo Music, A-R-R-I-G-O.
Anything else, or just this one last song?
Yeah, I'm going to play another angry kind of protesty song here.
Well, safe travels to your family, your wife.
Yeah.
And we're happy to have you around a little or a lot longer. And I would just remind everybody that Jeff has one more song, and then we have a whole remaining hour of local music. So please stay tuned. Don't touch that dial. We want the stream to... We want to test the stream and see how many people we can get.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, tune in.
Thanks.
Tune in, turn on, and don't drop out, though. I am a white man in a white man's world in the United States. Give me some more. I got a big white house, a car that swallows gas, a government that's willing to cover my... Keep the prices low and the benefits large. Keep the other ones out of our backyards. Push them back across the border, out of our homes. Used to do it face to face. Now I hear we're using drones. Privilege. Privilege, yeah. I used to think I earned everything I got, working harder than the others who ain't got squat, by paying my dues and going to school, towing the line and playing it cool. I was following the rules that aren't even written down. I moved to the city from a Midwest town. I started this game with the big head start. Skin, gender, this American heart pumping, you guessed it, privilege. Privilege, yeah, yeah. Now listen up, I am the 99% in this American hood, but the 1% when you consider the world. I worry about my weight, or maybe I'm going bald. Meanwhile, my Afghani brother, he is down at the morgue. He's a look into the face of his only child, who was in the wrong place at an awkward time. And I'm watching all this stuff in the TV light, thinking there before the grace of God go wide. Cause there's a world full of people who are hungrier than me, angrier than me, downtrodden. You can see them. Yes, there's a different kind of world where the kids don't even make it home. Said they died down the alleyway, scared and alone. And now the man who pulled the trigger's got a lot on his mind. He turns to the bottle, the pills or the pipe. Uncle Sam, he's just a vision in the rearview mirror, just a whisper of a promise not loud enough to hear. So now he's trapped in a night that he can't leave, screaming, wake up, but every one of us is sleeping. If he's lucky, there's a net that's gonna catch his fall. But there ain't no guarantees, thanks and please stop calling for privilege. Privilege, yeah. Well, one man standing on the side of the street with a sign in his hand looking for something to eat. Another guy chilling in a $1,000 suit, but everybody's got a little something they could lose. Point your finger anywhere that you choose and feel better about yourself or feel like a loser. But you are privileged beyond someone else's wildest dreams. It's just a rung on the ladder in another man's scheme. I got more than him, he's got more than me. Where does it stop, Lord? How much do you need? A little room for your sister, room for your brother. Take what you need, leave a little back for others. Your privilege. Privilege, yeah, 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 privilege. Thank you. Thanks for listening, everybody. Appreciate that. Thanks, everybody out there in Radio Land. I'm Jeff Arrigo, and this has been the WEF Sessions.